Coastal Road Corp and Provincial Government of Cavite po.
And Secretary? Out of the 21, ho, ilan na yung nagsustart?
Coastal Road, anong the Coastal Road of Cavite po?
Cavite, what cities? Madam what Chair, places in Cavite?
Madam Chair, here we have a visual map po which we will circulate.
What places in Cavite?
Madam Chair, the breakdown is not here in the list, but it is actually indicated po in the visual which we will share with you po.
We cannot distinguish that if we don't know.
If I may po, Director Cunyado, may we call upon you to actually provide the details?
Ano yung coastal road? Enumerate mo kung anong bayan sa Cavite.
Thank you, Madam Secretary, Madam Chair. The list of all the issued ECC is about 21 as indicated in our project. There's a 21 ECC issued in the Manila Bay.
About the coastal road in Cavite, how many ECCs yun? At gaano kalaki yun? Anong bayan yun?
Sorry, ma'am.
Dito ng gulit. Kasi I talked to Bacor, they will not proceed with it. I just want to know if they're proceeding. Kasi I talked to them. Meron Bacor. I told them, you have to do beyond Cavitex. Maglumabas ka ng Cavitex, magdidimandahan tayo. Sabihin mo sa akin kung sino yung coastal road na yan.
Madam Chair, regarding doon sa reclamation for inside, that's about...
Coastal road, Cavite.
Coastal road, road in Cavite, that's about...
Cavite? Saan yon? Ba't nalilito ka na? Binigay mo na hindi mo alam?
Itong coastal road, Madam Chair, is 846 hectares.
O, saan yan? Saan nag-start yan?
This is the area that is applied by Manila Bay Land Commission, that is a Cavite.
Saan bayan yan?
In Cavitex, Madam Chair.
Ano?
Cavitex. Cavite.
Oh, Cavitex. Saan ng Cavitex? Ang laki ng Cavitex. Cavitex starts sa ano? Paranaque. Umikot yon papuntang Cavite. Oh, so sabi mo, saan to? Ako, huwag nyo gagawin sa akin yun. Tungunan nyo. Dumating ka dito, galing ka sa Cebu, ginulo mo kami lahat. Ilista mo sa akin ano yung coastal road na yan. Hindi namin alam yan. Nung nag-hearing kayo, gusto ko mag-attend, ayaw niya akong tinatago niya sa akin. Ano yan? Ano yung coastal na yan? I-explain mo sa akin yan. Anong bayan yan?
Chair, if I may.
Hindi namin alam yan. Ako, sinabi ko sa inyo, huwag niyong pakikialaman yung amin daan doon. We have four rivers going out of that bay. Where will the river go? The water of the river go? Sinasabi ko na palagi sa inyo yun. Ayaw kayo tumigil. Hindi ako pumayag dyan. Nagpunta sa akin yung mga gustong mag-reclaim doon. Hindi ako pumayag dyan. Sabi sa akin ni Senate DPWH Secretary Babe Singson noong 2015, Senadora, huwag ka papayag, babaha kayo ng 6 to 8 meters. 6 meters is 3-story building. Sinabi ko na yan, hindi kayo mapigil. Sabi mo sa akin kung ano yan. Hindi mapigil, maraming perang pinamigay eh. Sinabi ko na yan, tigilan na yan. We cannot afford it. You know, kaya ayaw ni Babe Singson yan. Yung Bacoor Imus, yung Cavitex lang, hindi nila ginawang aqueduct. Dapat poste yon para the water will come out to Manila Bay. Tinambakan nila. They had to construct a 9.5 billion water retarding facility sa Bacoor and Imus na hindi nga binayaran ng government, inutang sa JICA, 45 hectares. And ngayon, sinasabi sa akin ni Mayor Revilla, hindi na solve. Hindi na solve ang flooding. Oh, 9.5 billion water retarding facility. What is the logic of tatambakan mo ang dagat, ang bay, tapos gagawa ka ng bay sa land and spend 9.5 billion there? I cannot find the logic there. Oh, why are you doing this? Yeah. Why are you doing that?
Madam Chair, I'm just, obviously I just got here physically, but I have been listening attentively to the presentation through online.
Canceled ECC daw yan na ni-revive mo.
That's what I'm about to ask. Madam Chair, you're saying that there's already a may kumukontra na dito sa gagawin na ito. So it's not like nobody is talking about this. Number two, Madam Chair, they proceeded without giving us a heads up. You are talking about the chairperson of the Senate committee.
They don't want to invite me. Oh, and that's why I'm telling him, you won't invite me. I am the chairman of the Senate Committee on Environment and Natural Resources. You won't invite me. Tinataguan na po eh. And that is a protected area.
My God.
Legislated protected area. And that is entitled to a buffer zone. Na
definitely.
Only the protected area. It's entitled to a buffer zone. Bakit i-reclaim yung buffer zone?
That's unbelievable. And now we couldn't get an answer, Madam Chair.
Ako, chairman ng committee nyo, yan lang ang pinapakiusap tayo sa inyo. Wala naman akong hinihingi sa inyo just to protect our city from flooding. Hindi kayo mapigil?
Madam Chair, may I? In terms of the projects of the Cavite province land and reclamation.
Bumaha na nga sila. Ilang bumaha sila. Ito, hindi mo 9.5 billion a water retarding facility.
So the million-dollar question is what prompted you to reclaim the area?
Madam Chair,
reclaim the area, 10,000.
Madam Chair, you want to put that on record? Madam Chair, I'm still interested. What prompted them to... Yeah, but I wanted to hear their side, Madam Chair. I already have some conclusions on my mind, Madam Chair, but I wanted to hear their side.
Madam Chair, if I may...
Yes, please.
Madam Chair, if I may defer to you, Sec. Jonas, here on the process po, to clarify the process po.
Thank you, Senator Joel. Ang process po natin sa reclamation, so unang-una po dyan, nag-a-apply po sila ng reclamation project, yung local government unit po, hindi po private sector, local government. In this case, City of Manila or City of Parañaque or City of Baracoa. And then, before they apply for reclamation project, they will be applying from the DNR, the area clearance, and the ECC. And then, kung meron na po silang area clearance and ECC, then that's the time they apply for a reclamation project sa Philippine Reclamation Authority. The approving authority of all reclamations, in the past, PRA at NEDA po yan. But then during the last administration, it was PRA and the Office of the President. So basically, ang ginagawa lang po natin, ECC, yes, ma'am. So, yes, ma'am. So there are,
ECC.
ECC. There are instances, Madam Chair, Your Honor, that may mga cases po talaga ng mga reclamations that na even if we issue the ECC, the Office of the President or the PRA will not approve it.
The President about that.
Yeah.
He didn't know about that.
So yun po, Madam.
To the President, di ba I told you and I told Secretary Simato, I talked to the President. Itong reclamation ng bay namin, I always talk to the President. I talked to President Aquino during his time. And I talked to President Duterte during his time. Hindi alam ng mga presidente yan. Di ba sinabi ni Presidente, ayoko niyan reclamation kasi it's a source of corruption. So yun na reason, corruption.
Basically, ganun po yung process, Madam Chair, Your Honor.
Still the process. Let me ask about the process, yung ECC that you were talking about, di ba? How do you determine? Because you were saying the LGUs actually ask for it. All the LGUs na tatamaan ask for it.
And, well, sila po ang proponent.
Okay, man. Sila yung proponent, tapos dinala sa ECC. Then, dun sa DENR to issue yung ECC. What are you looking for before you approve and say, oh, this is up for reclamation?
Usually, Madam Chair, Your Honor, ang ECC po talaga, hindi naman po siya magsasabi whether the project will proceed or not. Ang tinitingnan lang po natin, Madam Chair, Your Honor, sa ECC ay yung mga potential impact. So titingnan po natin based on the scoping activity, ito po yung atin ng mga different stakeholders na possibly will be affected by the project and they will define what will be the coverage of the ECC.
Was there an instance na sa ECC na figure out yung impact tapos nagkamali kayo na iba pala dun sa inaaral nyo na sabi hindi babahayin, binaha pa rin or sabi pag ganito ang ginawa, wala namang effect, adverse effect, pero nagkaroon.
Ganito po,
what do you do after
Chair, Your Honor? Sa ECC, after identification the possible or potential impact, ito po ang pag-aaralan ng proponent. They will be hiring experts para mapag-aaralan kung ano yung impact. If the impact can be mitigated, ibig sabihin pwedeng ma-reduce, pwedeng maiwasan, ito po yung sasabihin nila, i-sasabihin sa DNR and we will evaluate if the mitigating measures will be adequate to prevent yung possible impact. Pag may mga enhancement na po, they will still be subject to study. So, ang ECC po is not only undertaken by DNR, but actually being evaluated by experts. Minsan kasama po yung academic institutions, sila po yung nag-aaral kung anong dapat. In this case, reclamation, may mga study po yan, may mga hydrologic...
800.
Madam Chair, requirement. So ito po yung subject ng ECC natin.
Madam Chair, with the permission of Senator or Majority Floor Leader.
Senator Binay kasi siya yung nagtatanong sa dito, yeah.
Hindi, tatanong ko lang ho, Mr. Cortez, yung pagkunyari nalaman niyo na yung mitigating measures. Meron ho bang kakayahan yung DNR to check kung talaga nasunod yung pinapagawa niyang mitigating measures?
Yes, Madam Chair. Yung ECC po, after identifying the mitigation measures, when we issue the ECC, based on sa, i-determine po ng DNR kung yung mitigating measures with the other stakeholders, yung mga academic institution, mga experts, kung kaya-kaya po na nating mamitigate yung impact. Ngayon, kung makita natin na pwede naman po mitigate, mabawasan or ma-prevent po yung impact, may issue na po natin ng environmental compliance certificates with several conditions.
Ola,
so, ito mga conditions na minomonitor po natin.
Ang inaano ko is pagtapos na yung project, namomonitor nyo ba kung sumunod sila dun sa napagkasundo ang mitigating measures?
Yes, madam. Ito po yung nangyari. Kaya may mga companies o may mga ganyang project na based on our monitoring, we need to penalize them or ang pinaka worst case scenario, Madam Chair, Your Honor, we suspend or we cancel the ECC if there is a blatant violation of the conditions provided under the ECC, Madam Chair, Your Honor.
Yeah, eh, pero Yusek, pagdating na dun sa party na yun, parang lubulubog na tayong lahat. Diba? Yun lang po, Madam Chairperson. Sen. Joel, please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Chair, Your Honor.
Sabi, yung 800 hectares na sinasabi niya, expire na ang ECC noon. At hindi na Cavitex yun nung matagal na. Ang Cavitex was taken over by the Pangilinan Group. Hindi na sila interesado doon. Nire-revive niya yon kasi may question tong ECC nung mga pumatong. Eh, tapusin nyo na yan kasi. Pwede.
Okay. I would just like to follow up.
Yun. Yung 800 hectares na yon was issued long time ago when ang may-ari pa ng Cavitex, si Birata, na pinagbili niya na sa Cavitex kay Manny Pangilinan Group. Expired na yun eh. O, ngayon gusto nilang i-revive yun kasi nagkakaproblema yung maliliit na pumatong doon. May patong yun eh. O, ba't hindi nyo patapusin yun? Ano ba yan? Kapal-kapal naman ang mukha niyo. Alam niyo nang babaha kami ng katakot-takot eh. Ayaw niyo patigilan niya. Sinabi ko na yan sa Bacoor eh. Na you cannot do it beyond Cavitex kasi babaha tayo lahat dito. Bumabaha na sila. Hindi nga nila masolve eh. Tinayuan na nga sila ng 9.8 billion na 9.5 billion na water retarding facility. Hindi masolve eh. Oh. Bakit mo i-resume na naman yan? Aba di, taga Cebu ka. Doon ka pumunta sa Cebu at guluhin mo yung Cebu. Huwag mo kami guluhin dito. We just want to live a quiet life here. Tigilan niyo ako. Magdidimandahan na tayo. Nagdimandahan na tayo ng katagal-tagal, 20 years doon sa Altec. Magdidimandahan na naman kami ngayon.
Madam Chair, if I may, under this present administration, we'll be looking very carefully at the reclamation policy as a whole. We realize there is a need for some very strong science because of the implications.
Hindi naman science yan.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Forever ka na lalabas sa bay, walang lalabasan eh. What will happen to us? Four River, Parañaque River, Las Piñas River, Zapote River, and Molino River. Because Molino River goes to Zapote River to go out of that side of Manila Bay. Hindi na science yan. It's, where will our water go? Kung sasarahan mo yung Manila Bay. Common sense naman yun eh. Where will our water go? 2 million people? Bacoor, Las Piñas, and Parañaque. We're 2 million. 2 million people, 2 million household, hindi 2 million people. My God.
Madam Chair, if
Madam
I may.
Chair. Oh. Madam Chair, if I may lang. Kanina yung binanggit ni Senator Nancy Bean, tungkol dun sa problema na na-approve yung ECC. I would just like to flash this on screen, Madam Chair. What happened in Coron, Palawan? After po yan na na-issue yung ECC, ngayon po, inalis yung mga mangrove forest dyan. Ayan na po yung itsura ngayon. And now, PRA is asking for the forfeiture. Patignan nyo po yung, lugar, yung itsura ngayon, Madam Chair. So, pagkatapos nyan, Tsaka natin nahabulin yung binabanggit nga, I mean, I share the concern of Senator Binay. Parang, what are we doing? Ito ho, anong update naman ho dito? Tigil na po ba ito?
Madam Chair, if I may, may request you seek Mitch Una to respond.
Mitch, please.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair, Senator Joel Villanueva. The status of the Coron Reclamation Project right now is that the Environmental Compliance Certificate that was previously issued has been cancelled, and they have filed a motion for reconsideration, and that is pending now, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Yusek Mitch. But again, Madam Chair, it's a classic example na lumabas yung ECC, ni-reclaim, tinanggal yung mga mangroves. Ayan po yung nangyari. I mean, we don't want to see this kind of picture all over our country. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Siguro, ano na, you have to re-examine your stand to this reclamation project. Di ba? Nakakatakot to eh. Oh, kawawa naman kami eh. We have been trying to take care of our cities. Tapos dadating kayo dito out of nowhere and then aaprubahan nyo yung mga ito. Hindi naman kayo taga-amin eh. Tapos eh, naghi-hearing sila eh. Hindi ko ma-access ang hearing eh. Oh, tinatago nila sa akin. Bakit nyo pinababayaan ng mga manager nyo na ganyan? Ako, chairman of the Committee on Environment and Natural Resources, hindi ko nga ma-access ang hearing eh. Ayaw bigay sa akin eh. Ikaw? Huwag nyo gagawin sa amin yan. Hindi kami papayag dyan. Baka akala nyo makakalusot kayo. Kinausap ko na si President Duterte dyan noong time mo eh. Hindi niya alam yan eh. Baka yung sinasabi sa'yo na naglalakad mo, nagbubulaan sa'yo. And I will talk to President about this. This time, I will talk to President Bongbong Marcos. I have talked to all president about the reclamation there. I'm telling you, gawin nyo gusto nyo sa ibang lugar, huwag doon sa amin kasi hirap na kami. You know, it took me 10 years to clean my river so that there will be no flooding. Tapos, sasarahan nyo yung daan ng river ko. Ba yan? Took me 10 years to do that. From 2013 to 2021. 10 years. 30 kilometers of river. I cleaned 30 kilometers of river. Ba't hindi sasama loob ko? Sino naman magtsatsagang maglinis ng 30 kilometers of river? Tapos sasara mo yung dadaanan ng river ko? Ano naman kami? Why? Anong reason ko to spend 10 years of my life tapos sasara mo yung dadaanan ng river ko? I spent 10 years of my life cleaning that river. Yeah, I'm so passionate about this. And we have passed that legislated protected area yun. Legislated kasi nga hindi nyo pinakikinggan pag executive protected area. Ano yun eh, 2007 eh, declare na yun ng president. Protected area. Hindi naman nila pinakinggan it. That's why I had to legislate it. And I had to spend a lot of money to support my lawyer para ipaglaban yun. Oh. Ano yun eh? 2007 declared na yun na executive order. Oh. Hindi nila pinakinggan. Oh. Hindi ni-legislate. At declared yun Ramsar. Ang Ramsar kasi, we are a co-signatory to the Ramsar Treaty. So, ang pag co-signatory ka doon, you are mandated to protect that Ramsar listed wetland of international importance to protect it from destruction. So, may Ramsar na kami, may legislation pa kami, may executive order kami. Walang makapigil na mag-issue ng ECC. What do you think is the reason for that? Tapos ako, yan lang pinapakiusap ko sa inyo. Huwag nyo na kaming pakialaman. Di mapigil. Pero. Baguhin na natin ang topic.
Madam Chair. Last question na po. But I also...
Senator Nancy, as long as it's a different topic, we will allow you to raise your questions.
I just joined our chairperson, call niya, na to siguro finally to come out with a policy pagdating nga dito sa reclamation. Moving on to another topic, hingi lang ako ng update.
Sobrang ahirap ko dyan. 20 taon na yan.
Opo, as chairperson po ng Committee on Tourism, hingi lang ako ng update dito sa 6 Tourist Beach Destination Program po ng DNR.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. I'll turn over to you, Sec. Jonas Leones, for that update. If I may just add, Madam Chair, that we commit to the review of the policy on reclamation po. This is something that we have said po from the very start. Thank you very much, Madam Chair.
Thank you very much, Secretary. I hope this will be a different time for all of us.
Madam Chair, maybe you're referring to the GEM sites, yung green economy model sites. These are actually located sa Coron, El Nido, Puerto Galera, Panglao, Region 7, and Siargao. Basically, we want to replicate what we have done in Boracay and Manila Bay, which includes rehabilitation of destroyed mangrove areas, restore the water quality in these areas. And we have, at for 2023, we have total budget for allocated for these five GEMs for 2019 to 2022. We have already allocated for Coron, 22 million. El Nido, 22 million, and Puerto Galera, the same, 22 million. Panglao in Cebu, in Region 7, 23 million, and Siargao, 26 million, Madam Chair. As I said, Madam Chair, we will be replicating the activities we have undertaken in the different sites that we have already rehabilitated, which includes rehabilitation of informal settlers in coordination with other department agency like DSUD for the relocation of informal settlers and the local government unit for enforcing our environmental laws in order to protect these five GEM sites, Madam Chair. Thank you, Your Honor.
And Yusek, meron na ho ba kayo in the pipeline for other beach destinations?
Madam Chair, if I may respond to that, we are now in discussions po with Secretary Cristina Frasco and also Secretary Denr, because ang vision po ni Secretary Frasco would be to have a national collaboration with the DNR in terms of ecotourism and enhancement of the protected area, so that in fact we may include this in the tourism industry's push towards sustainable tourism. So in fact, po, there was to be a meeting this afternoon. We just needed to reset po because of the budget and because of other circumstances. But this has been an ongoing conversation already with Secretary Cristina and Secretary Denr on collaboration with the DILG and the DOT on the Boracay-like approach towards sustainable tourism for the country. Thank you very much, Madam Chair.
And siguro, Sec, baka pwede pakidagdag naman hutong Pasig River. Alam mo natin, when we go to other countries, yung river cruise nila or yung mga ganong tourism event na pwedeng gawin. And napakalaki ho ng potential ng Pasig River. Sana nga ho kasama to dun sa talagang marirehabilitate na.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. I'll defer to Yusek Jonas because we do have funding for Pasig River rehabilitation as well po, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Thank you, Madam Chair, Your Honor. We're happy to report, Madam Chair, Your Honor, that for the Pasig River, it is being part of the Manila Bay rehabilitation. We have been continuously cleaning up the Pasig River in coordination or in collaboration with the private sector. I don't know, Madam Chair, if you heard that one private company has pledged to dredge the whole Pasig River. So this is ongoing as part of our Manila Bay rehabilitation. For the Bulacan side, Your Honor, Mr. Senator, I'm also from Bulacan. We're also pipeline, included in the pipeline also is the rehabilitation of the Mekawayan Marilao Obando River. As you said, this has been adjudged as one of the polluted river. So it being part of the Manila Bay of the world, it is also part of our rehabilitation because we believe that if we cannot clean all the river system connected to Manila Bay, we will not be successful in the rehabilitation of Manila Bay. So rest assured that we will continuously clean up the Manila Bay, Your Honor.
Sige.
Yusek, I will monitor that, Yusek. Yes, the chairperson is correct in stating that it used to be the dirtiest river in the world,
yeah,
which is a black eye in our beloved province.
Yun lang, Yusek. Sana panawagan ko lang ho bago matapos sana yung term ko in 3 years, magkakaroon na ho ng pwede nang mag-offer ang ating DOT ng isang Pasig River tour or something similar to that na ginagawa natin when we go abroad. Yan lang po, Madam Chairperson. Thank you po.
Yes, Madam Mayor.
In connection with the river, I just want to manifest, kasi baka magkagulo na naman tayo dito, na pumaya, yung DPWH kinausap ko na, nagigive up na natin yung Parañaque Spillway. Kasi sabi ng Secretary of DPWH, that study was made in the 1970s. Outdated na yun. So ayaw na namin ang Las Piñas Parañaque and even Muntinlupa nung Parañaque Spillway. So kasi gusto pang i-hear ng DNR yon. So I'm just manifesting na nag-usap-usap na kami na hindi, kasi yung assumption in the 1970 is different now, that 1970 is 50 years ago. So yung mga assumption noon, iba na ngayon. And may problema na nga kami sa Manila Bay, dadagdagan pa ng ng Laguna Lake. So siguro you should devise rehabilitation of Laguna Lake by themselves, and then kami naman we will devise the rehabilitation of Manila Bay in our side para kanya-kanya tayong pag-solve ng problema kasi marami tayong problema nowadays. Okay? So I just want to make the manifestation kasi nag-gusto pa nilang mag-hear doon. For us, it's out of the question. We will not agree to that. So i-abandon na natin yung Parañaque Spillway na yun.
Madam Chair, if I may po, yeah, just to inform Madam Chair that we have had several conversations with Secretary Babe Singson as well. So he has the holistic view po of the problems of Metro Manila. So we could continue to consult with him po specifically on this one as well.
Ano? Nandiyan pa ba siya? Eh, umalis na rin. We recognize Senator Bongo. Siya yung... not there? I just want to ask if Senator Bongo is not there, is Senator Aimee interested in asking question? Nawawala sila. So we'll recognize, while waiting for them, we'll recognize Senator Villanueva.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Be very quick and let me first of all thank our friends from the DENR. Secretary, congratulations for your confirmation. I have a lot of friends in the DNR family, especially with the si Yusek Kuna, lagi kong binabati yan for the past so many years. But I'm trying to fill in for Senator Tulfo, Madam Chair. When if he comes back, I will yield to him. But while waiting for him, I was listening attentively to the questions raised and your initiatives in order to preserve and appreciate the presence of our Sierra Madre. I think we are all aware of what happened during the last super typhoon. And Sierra Madre, which stretches for 500 kilometers, has shielded the entire Luzon, no? Metro Manila, Cagayan, Bulacan, Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Nueva Ecija, Quirino, Aurora, Quezon, Rizal, Laguna. It stabilizes the water flow and soil to prevent typhoon-related calamities, and its terrain provides a buffer, slowing down and often taking the impact of typhoons. However, the rugged mountain slopes can mitigate strong winds. The forests also absorb heavy rains. We just wanted to find out. I actually went to San Miguel, Bulacan, personally the day after Typhoon Carding hit our beloved province. And of course, everyone is thankful that we have Sierra Madre, but we wanted to find out if part of your budget in preservation of Sierra Madre na-cut din kasama dun sa binabanggit niyo po kanina. So what are your current programs for the conservation and the management of the mountain range, Secretary?
Thank you very much, Madam Chair, Mr. Senator. I will defer to our FMB director so he can talk about current programs, and then we can break down the budget for you, Madam Chair, after which I will defer to Yusek Anate. Director Parian.
Thank you, Madam Secretary, Madam Chair. Good afternoon, Senator Joel Villanueva. Regarding the situation in Sierra Madre Mountain, as for the information of this honorable body, we have a total land area in Sierra Madre, no, based on the non-BREA land cover data, a total of 1,417,472.81 hectares. Out of this, Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, the following closed forest, 553,637. In hectares, sir. And open forest, we have 565.43.
Sorry to interject, yes, sir. Just so we can be faster, no? Just the allocation of funds, how much are we looking at? Was it affected because of the cut? How much do we need? We need to help. We wanted to find out how much was allotted for Sierra Madre.
Madam Chair, if we may.
Secretary.
You sit there.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Madam Chair, Senator Villanueva, the budget allocated for Northern Sierra Madre Natural Park for 2023 is 9.9 million pesos, and this is intended for demarcation.
Let me put on record na nanlata ako, Madam Chair. 9.9 million. 500 kilometers.
Updating of the management plan, Mr. Chair, and monitoring of the flora and fauna.
PMB.
Yes, ma'am. And of course, there's also provision for hiring of the protected area superintendent and park rangers.
What was your proposed budget for that, for that particular item?
For NGP, Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, we will get the specific budget on the
national training.
Oh yeah, because it's on the province. Sa Penro, ma'am, nakapasok, aside from the PA, meron din tayong NGP sa Penro.
Sa NGP.
Hiwalay pa.
Hiwalay siya. Pa.
Yes, ma'am. Opo. Kasama po siya dun sa 248.
Yeah. Kasama na ba yun dun sa... Hindi pa. So, i-add mo pa dyan yung 11, but still. 20 million.
And then NGP po.
500 kilometers. Maliit lang. Pinag-ip lang tayo lahat ng Sierra Madre nitong nakarang super typhoon.
Sabi nila.
yung may assessment na po ba tayo after the typhoon and I'm sure medyo hindi pa nako-cover lahat, no? But siguro yun na lang. Again, just to place on record, we're here to help. We wanted to find out how much we need. Decent, hindi naman 9.9 million for 900 kilometers. Siguro, pa-submit na lang. I wanted to expedite, eh, no? And then next yung question ko sa Kaliwa Dam. Ano ba talaga? Will it benefits outweigh the cost? How will, alam mo yung million-dollar question lagi to, how will it affect the livelihood of our people? Will it prevent or help in preventing flood flow to the communities below it?
To make a comment on that and ask you, what do you think? They said that the Angat Dam is 50 years old. Anytime it can go. So, yung Kaliwa Dam is the alternative. Otherwise, may problem ang Metro Manila as a source of water. That's what how they explain it to me. But I want to hear from the DNR what is the explanation there. Because hindi ba yung Angat Dam is 50 years old. So, anytime it can go. So, ano ang kapalit ng Angat Dam?
Madam Chair, if I may, and I'll turn over to NWRB Director Bill David in a moment. But if we can just state that Metro Manila is already water stressed. And so without a new water supply, we will continue to be challenged in terms of domestic use po. And so Angat is a multipurpose dam. And therefore, there are other uses rather than supplying Metro Manila. So if there were to be structurally an impact because of an earthquake or some other type of event, there will be other areas that will be affected, not just for domestic supply, but agriculture and energy, as well as geographically Bulacan and surrounding areas. So if I may just now turn over to NWRB Director Bill David for the comment on Kaliwa and the other supply issues. Thank you po.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Madam Secretary. And of course, good morning po, Madam Chair and Senator Villanueva. As for the Kaliwa Dam, actually, Madam Chair, this was proposed, no, or being implemented by the NWSS, no? And of course, the main purpose of this Kaliwa Dam is to serve as a redundant, no, redundant alternative water source, no, for primarily for Metro Manila. Alam naman po natin is the, with the increasing demand, no, of water for Metro Manila, and since sabi niyo nga po around 50 years diyan na po nanggagaling, no, yung water supply for Metro Manila, and since then, no, naging double na po ang population ng Metro Manila. And it's not only Metro Manila ang maasa po ngayon sa Angat Dam, no, andiyan po yung Bulacan, no. I think majority part of Bulacan also relies on the water supply being provided by the Angat Dam. Kasama na rin po dyan yung Rizal and part po ng Cavite province. Kaya with this increasing demand po, Madam Chair, ay nagkaroon po talaga ng need na, no, to develop, no, alternative water source, no. Although isa rin po tinatignan natin dito is yung as another program of the government, yung demand management naman po, no. So usually po kasi yung supply naman natin hindi naman talaga nagbabago, no, finite ang supply natin. So we are also resorting to water demand management, no? Yung pagmamanage naman ng pangangailangan natin. At on record po, medyo malakas gumamit, no, yung tao, no, yung Pilipino sa mga sa tubig. So yun po yung isa nating in-address. But while doing that, Madam Chair, there's also a need, no, to develop, no, mga alternative water source in case na magkaroon nga po, no, as also a protection to disaster. Hopefully, hindi naman po mangyayari yan. Isang ano rin po as a parang alternative water source in case magkaroon po ng disaster po Metro Manila.
I suppose you have a feasibility study about it, di ba? And in the feasibility study itself, what does it say? Ito yung ano, yung portions, and I let me put on record, Madam Chair, that I will yield to my good friend Senator Tulfo after this last question, Your Honor. Pwedeng marinig kay Executive Director David, please.
Yes po, meron pong ginawa yan, feasibility and likewise yung engineering study po. But ang ano po kasi in WSS po ang
recent... Kung ano na lang, bigyan mo kami ng recommendation nyo din. Would you agree with that feasibility study? Because I'm sure prior to that, meron na rin ngayong mga studies. Siguro.
Madam
yes,
Chair.
Madam Chair.
Madam Chair, if I may just to conclude on the status of Kaliwa, may turn over to Sir Jonas for the status report.
Madam Chair, thank you, Madam Secretary. Just to inform the Honorable Senator that aside from the feasibility that you're asking the NWRB, the Kaliwa River Forest Reserve is actually a proclaimed protected area under Presidential Proclamation 1636. Na masungi po. Apo. So, sa under the PP... Proclamation 1636, there is an ongoing PASA activities kasi titingnan po natin na requirement po ito sa legislation, yung PASA. And then we have already drafted the PA management zoning and then no PA management yet, plan, and then no IPAP account yet because it is not yet a protected area. But we have already surveyed yung mga occupants in the area. And we will be completing those inventory. And then we have already inventoried the existing facilities there. And then for the initial component naman po, meron kaming mga study rin po on resources on the forest and wildlife being parang inventory po natin yung mga wildlife. Itinan po natin kung anong category papasok siya sa protected area. So basically, these are the updates on the Kaliwa Watershed Madam Chair, Your Honor.
Madam Chair, as...
to make a manifestation that Masungi Geo Reserve, 40% belongs to the Upper Marikina Protected Area and 60% belongs to this protected area of Kaliwa Dam. Now, the Upper Marikina River Protected Area is legislated. This one is by presidential decree, which we hope to legislate this coming Congress. Yeah, that's it. Okay.
Madam Chair, I will yield to Senator Tulfo, who's been wanting to ask questions, Madam Chair. I will yield to...
thank you.
Sasabihin ko sana more senior, but thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Senator Joel Villanueva, Majority Floor Leader. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair. The most beautiful Madam Chair. anyway, first of all, I would like to commend and thank the DNR for always acting on complaints that my action center would refer to them, cases pertaining to environmental issues. And FYI, you've always been our last recourse, last line of defense. Kasi nga po, palagi pag lumalapit kami para ireklamo yung mga mababawang poultry, piggery, yung mga rivers na napupollute because of factories na pabaya, yung Senro, Emro, Menro ba yan? Menro and Senro, hindi po sila umaaksyon. Pero pag lumalapit po kami sa inyo, talagang umaaksyon po kayo. At halos lahat po ng mga nilapit po namin sa inyo, naaksyonan nyo po. And for that, maraming salamat po talaga. Sana you'll keep doing that. And also, I would like to tell you guys na I fully support your proposed budget for 2023. Yan po talagang stand ko sa lahat po ng mga inatin akong hearing. Never po ako na tumutol. Always ako'y pumapayag na ego yung proposed budget because I'm not an expert pagdating po sa pamamalakad ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno humingi po ng budget sa ating pamalaan. Okay, now having said that, meron lang po akong a few questions. Kinukomment ko rin po yung DNR kasi marami po ako nabasa ng mga articles. I did some research about dun sa mga nahuli yung mga illegal logging, yung mga violators pertaining to environmental issues. Ang tanong ko po, nakakasuhan ho ba yon? Meron ba tayong record na nakasuhan? Ano na po nangyari sa mga kasong yon? There were quite a few cases na filed
And I just want to make sure na itong mga kasong ito talagang nag-prosper at umaten po yung DNR kasi kayo po ang complainant. So inaten niyo po para hindi ma-dismiss yung mga kasong yon. Yun po ang gusto ko munang tanungin sa inyo.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, Senator Tulfo. I'll yield po to you, Sec. Jonas Leones, for the report on the cases. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Thank you, Madam Chair, Your Honor. Regarding the question of Senator Tulfo, yes, Mr. Chair, Your Honor, there are a lot of cases that have been filed against violators pertaining to violations of PD 705 for our violation for violations under our forestry laws. We are also filed cases against encroachments in our protected areas and other environmental laws. Madam, we're just looking for the list. Maybe in a while we will provide you the list of the, those cases that were filed against these violators, Your Honor, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Yusek. Jonas, kasi importante po sa atin yun para sa kalaman po ng taong bayan, malaman nila na seryoso po talaga tayo pag nagpa-file po tayo ng kaso, pag nag-apply po tayo, eh talagang tinutuloyan natin at hindi po natin pinapabayaan hanggat sa meron talaga makulong. Kasi so far, wala pa ako nanig na press releases na nagsasabing matapos ma-arrest ng DNR, ito'y kinasuhan at ito'y nakakulong na ngayon at 5 to 10 years, whatever, kung ilang taon yung kanilang parusa at mapaparusahan na yung mga nahuli para nagbunga naman po yung pagod ng DNR. Yun po yung gusto ko lang sana masiguro. So, doon po sa mga na-apprehend ng mga taga-DNR sa illegal logging, illegal mining, kung ano pa man po yun na environmental issues, sana po natuluyan. Give us a record.
Yes, we'll provide as soon as possible, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Thank you. Doon po sa Kaliwa Dam, very controversial po ito. In fact, I talked to several environmentalists and tutol nga po sila dito. Ano pong stand ng DNR?
Thank you very much, Madam Chair, Honorable Senator. I will turn over to Yusek June Adobo for the reply. Thank you po.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Madam Chair. Right now, hindi pa po naibibigay yung ECC nila. Gawa po, hindi pa tapos yung zoning ng protected areas right now. They're in the process of doing that.
Okay. So pinag-aralan niyo pa po ng mabuti kung yung ba'y karapat-dapat na ituloy o hindi. Kasi nga po, marami din pong ginawang pag-aaral yung mga environmentalist group tungkol dyan na sinasabi nilang may mga alternative naman po aside from Kaliwa Dam kung kayo na kailangan magkaroon tayo ng import supply ng tubig sa NCR at iba pang lugar na pwede ma-provide sa ng Kaliwa Dam. So I think masusing pag-aaral po siguro ang dapat gawin nyo and you should talk to all stakeholders. Dapat itimbangin natin.
Kasi the PAMBI is on it, no? They're reviewing the proposal, the project.
Okay, so habang pinag-aaralan niyo po yan, dapat pag-aralan din niyo po kung halimbawa yan po'y naaprobahan o for whatever reason, yung pong project na yan ay gumulong, ano po yung mga livelihood program na meron kayong nakalaan para sa mga madi-display, especially itong mga IPs natin. Pero kung ako personally, tutol po ako sa Kaliwa Dam. Pero kung yan ay isa lang naman akong tao, isang senador lang ako, eh kung marami po talaga ang may gusto, or even if the administration would go for it, then sino ba naman ako? Although I would right now tell you guys na tutol ako. Personally, tutol po ako sa Kaliwa Dam. Now, Bando, ano po yung plano nyo tungkol po dun sa livelihood program para dun sa mga apektuhan nitong project nyo sa Kaliwa Dam? Isakali man po ito'y matuloy, especially po yung mga IPs na umaasa lang po ng livelihood program nila dun sa paglalagyan ng Kaliwa Dam yun sa Sierra Madre.
Yung project proposal naman, Your Honor, Madam Chair, no? Nandun yung kanilang, they spelled out the plan on the IPs that will be affected. But by the way, wala pang hindi pa nga nagbigay ng free informed prior consent ang IP dito. Kaya yung ACC was put on hold, no? Kasi post condition natin yung issuance ng IPs, no?
On hold po yung ICC, yung ano ngayon, ECC. Oh,
kasi ito okay. Ang for the project to proceed. The
kasi I read an article na meron po ata nag-issue ng nag-request ng TRO mula sa korte para mapigilan po yung pagtuloy ng project. Although from articles that I've read, yung previous administration ata ay more on go for it.
Madam Chair, may I just interject? Because we have an update on the ECC. If I can, as I understand it from the team, the Kaliwa Dam has a post condition on its ECC, so it has been issued. But there is a condition that is put in place. There is no consent from the indigenous people in the area, and therefore it cannot be acted on.
Okay, so because there's no consent, so hindi ho matutuloy?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, Madam Chair. I may defer to you, Sec. Jonas, so you can elaborate.
Well, kung hindi natuloy, then for me, it's music to my ears. Kasi nga po, alam naman natin, yung Sierra Madre, that's what we call the backbone of Luzon. Yan po ay nagpoprotekta sa maraming lugar sa ating bansa, especially sa NCR, pag may mga dumating po mga bagyo na pipigilan po, nasasangga po ng Sierra Madre. So, I would really like that Sierra Madre be protected. So, go ahead po, you said to us.
Thank you, Madam Chair, Your Honor. Thank you, Madam Secretary. So, ito po, tama po yung sinabi ng ating kalihim, Secretary Loizaga, na even if we issue the ECC for environmental concerns, but there is a post-condition that the project cannot commence unless they comply with this post-condition, that is the consent, to get the consent of the indigenous peoples in the area.
Okay. Ngayon po kasi ako nabasa ng article ni Yusek Jonas na kung saan nag-offer po ata ang DNR ng housing sa mga IPs at tumututol po yung IPs. Kasi nga naman po, meron nga silang bahay pero wala naman silang trabaho, wala silang pagkain, ano yung nilang bahay. So ang importante po talaga sa mga IPs, yung livelihood. I think that's first and foremost that should be addressed first, you know, bago tayo magtayo ng kung anumang project na maapektuhan po silang lahat, itong mga IPs. Kasi sila po palaging api dito eh. Tuwing meron pong ginagawang proyekto ng ating gobyerno patungkol po sa environment, na maapektuhan po yung environment natin, eh sila po yung unang-unang naapektuhan. Sila po yung nakakawawa dito.
Madam Chair, you said...
Dito nga po pumapasok yung sinasabi ko po, yung quote ko, yung isang sikat na American activist, sinasabi niya, the opposite of poverty is not wealth. The opposite of poverty is justice.
Yes, Madam Chair, Your Honor. Tama po kayo doon. Kaya nga po very strict yung aming post condition. We need to make sure that the welfare of the IPs are considered before any project implementation. So, in case there will be housing that will be offered to the IPs, ito po yung pag-uusapan pa rin sa the table kasi sa amin po, ang concern lang namin if there will be the project and there will be in need of relocating this IPs, kung meron man, kung matutuloy man yung project, hanggang area lang po kami mag-relocate. But for the housing projects, we need to coordinate with the Department of Housing and Department of Housing po and Urban Authority.
So, sorry. So meron po kayong offer na housing?
So far po, wala po kaming...
Okay. So, mali yung article ata nabasa ko.
Wala po kaming
okay.
Housing.
So, good. Now, lastly, ang gusto ko lang po talaga, makuha po yung record ng mga nahuli nyo. And very commendable po yun. Kayo po yung umaresto. Ibig sabihin, kayo po yung natatrabaho at na-aresto nyo po, na-apprehend nyo po yung mga illegal loggers at yung mga violators ng abuses against the environment. Gustong-gusto ko po yan. Pero kailangan lang po natin ng record talaga para sa taong bayan to na makikita seryoso po tayo sa ating trabaho. Yun lang po. Maraming salamat.